my students. So we were studying about the uses of microorganisms. So we saw that they are used for making medicines, food items, antibiotics, vaccines. They help to improve the fertility of soil. They help to keep our environment clean. So many uses. So today we can study about the harmful effects of microorganisms. So there are some microorganisms spoil our food, clothes, leather, and some causes diseases to human beings, not only to human beings, to other animals and plants also. So today, now we can study about the disease causing microorganisms in humans. Okay, so these microorganisms that cause diseases are called pathogens. So the microorganisms that cause diseases are called pathogens. Okay, so how these pathogens enter into our body? So pathogens enter into our body through food, air, water, and also by direct contact with an infected person. Or some pathogens are carried through some insects or some animals also. Okay, so the diseases that spread from one person to another through air, water, food, or through physical contact, that diseases are called communicable diseases. So what are communicable diseases? Communicable diseases are the diseases that spread from a person to another person. So the diseases that spread from one person to another person through air or water or food or direct contact. So that diseases that spread from one person to another person are called communicable diseases. So typhoid, cholera, tuberculosis, chickenpox, all these spread from one person to another person. But you know, for example, heart disease or cancer and all, they won't spread from one person to another. So that the cancer, heart diseases, all these are not communicable diseases. So communicable diseases means the diseases that spread from one person to another. So we study some diseases spread through air. So this occurs through the little droplets thrown out by an infected person who sneezes or coughs. So when they sneeze or cough, what happens? The droplets will come out from their mouth and nose. And someone standing close by can breathe in these droplets, and the microbes get a chance to start a new infection in that person. For example, when a person is suffering from common cold, when he sneezes, the droplets of moisture carrying thousands of viruses are spread into the air. And the other person, when he breathes this air, the virus will enter into his body also. So many examples, common cold, pneumonia, tuberculosis, all these diseases spread through air. Okay, then some diseases spread through water. So this occurs if the excreta from someone suffering from a disease such as cholera get mixed with drinking water used by people living nearby. So the cholera causing microbes will enter into a healthy person through the water they drink and cause disease in them. So what we should do? We should drink only clean and boiled water. Otherwise, if you are drinking contaminated water, the germs may enter into our body and we will be affected by diseases like cholera. And for that diseases that spread through air, how we can prevent it? When anybody is sneezing or cough, what happens? They should cover their mouth and nose with a handkerchief and can prevent the spread of the disease. And again, some diseases spread through food. when flies go and sit on some garbage and all, the pathogens or the disease causing microorganisms will be present in that garbage. That pathogens may enter into the body of this flies and all. So they will be sticking to the body of the flies. And when flies sit on this garbage and animal excreta, the pathogen stick to their bodies. And when these flies sit on uncovered food, they may transfer the pathogens into the food. And whoever eats the contaminated food is likely to get sick. So avoid consuming uncovered food. So how we can prevent these diseases? We should keep our food items covered. Don't keep our food items uncovered. If any food item is uncovered, you should not use that food item. Keep your food items, cook your food items in a clean, healthy environment and always keep it covered also. So we study about diseases that spread through air, water and food. Now again, there are some insects and animals which act as carriers of disease-causing microbes. You know about rabies. It is carried by what? Dog or some other animals. Then housefly. You already studied. If housefly, after sitting on garbage and all, pathogens may stick into their body. And when they come and sit on our food, pathogens will enter into our food. And if we consume that food, pathogens will enter into our body and we will be affected by disease. So houseflies are also carriers of some diseases. Then about mosquito, you know, mosquitoes carry so many diseases. For example, malaria. Malaria is caused by a protozoa called Plasmodium vivax. And this protozoa is carried by mosquitoes. So when one mosquito bites a person who is suffering from malaria, along with blood, that protozoa will enter into a mosquito's body. Then again, when this mosquito go and bites another person, protozoa will enter into that person's, healthy person's body, and that person also will be affected by the disease. So this Plasmodium vivax or malarial parasite that is carried by female Anopheles mosquito. So the different types of mosquitoes are there, and female Anopheles mosquito carries this pathogen. And male mosquitoes, they usually don't suck blood. They are sucking the juices of plants and all. But females, they are laying egg, so they need more nutritious food, and they have the ability to suck blood from animals and human beings. Okay, so malarial parasite is carried by female Anopheles mosquito, or you know, dengue fever. It is also caused by a virus, and that virus is carried by which mosquito? Female Aedes mosquito is carrying the virus of dengue fever. Then about elephantiasis or filariasis, that filarial worm. It is called Bucheraria bancrofti, and that filarial worm is also carried by, mainly by, Culex mosquito. So mosquitoes are carriers of so many diseases. And how we can control these mosquitoes? Where do these mosquitoes lay egg? They lay egg in stagnant water. So we should not let water collect anywhere, like coolers, tires, flower pot, etc. By keeping the surroundings clean and dry, we can prevent mosquitoes from breeding. So if we are not allowing to stagnate water here and there, mosquitoes won't get water for laying egg, and we can prevent the increasing number of mosquitoes. Usually in summer season, we can see there won't be so many mosquitoes. But when rainy season starts, you can see the number of mosquitoes increases, and diseases that spread by mosquitoes also increases. You can hear about this dengue fever and all during rainy season. So we should not allow water to stagnate here and there, which is the breeding place for mosquitoes. Okay, then so some of the common diseases affecting humans, their mode of transmission, and a few general methods of prevention that we can study. So that is written in this table. So what is written in the table? Some of the diseases, causative microorganism, their mode of transmission, and the preventive measurement for that diseases. So first disease TB. TB is tuberculosis. And which is the microorganism? It is caused by a bacteria. So tuberculosis is caused by a bacteria. So if an example for a disease caused by bacteria is asked, you can write TB or tuberculosis. Mode of transmission. So it transmits mainly through air. And what about measles? That is caused by a virus. So microorganism is virus, and mode of transmission is again air. Then chickenpox. Microorganism, causative microorganism is a virus, and mode of transmission is through air and by contact with the infected person. Then polio is also caused by a virus, and it also spread through air and water. So what are the preventive measures? How we can prevent the spreading of these diseases? One is isolation. So means what? Keep the patient in complete isolation. So if anybody is affected by any one of these diseases, chickenpox or any other disease, keep them in complete isolation. So give a special room for them and avoid contacting with that persons also. Then what? Things away from others. So keep the personal belongings of the patient away from those of the others. Otherwise what happened? If one person who is affected by chickenpox, he read one book, and after that you are taking that book, what happens? The virus will come into your body also when you touch that book. So keep the personal belongings of the patient also away from others. And nowadays you know all about this, you will understand easily. Because now we are taking care of, to prevent our body from getting affected by COVID-19. So you know what are the preventive measures. Then third one is vaccination. So there is vaccination for chickenpox. So vaccination should be given at the suitable age. So if vaccination is given, no problem. That person won't be affected by the disease. Okay. Now look next one. Next disease is cholera. And which is the causative microorganism? Bacteria. And mode of transmission? Through water and food. So cholera spread through water and food. So you should drink clean and boiled water. You should eat food that is cooked in a clean surroundings, and that is covered also. Okay, then typhoid, it is also caused by bacteria and it spread through water. So what are the preventive measures? Personal hygiene, maintain personal hygiene and good sanitary habits. Good sanitary habits means what? You should pass out your waste materials only in the toilet. After going to toilet, you should wash with soap your body and also your hands also. Okay. Then what? Cooked food. You should consume properly cooked food and boiled drinking water. And again, vaccination can prevent this disease. So vaccination should be given at the proper age also. Okay. Then what is the next disease? Hepatitis A. And it is, which is the causative microorganism? Virus. And it spread through water. So what are the preventive measures? You should drink boiled water. And for hepatitis also there is vaccination. So you should take vaccination at the correct age. Then next disease, what? Malaria. It is caused by protozoa called Plasmodium vivax. and it is carried or transmitted by female Anopheles mosquito. So what all things we can do to prevent this disease? Use mosquito net. So if there are a lot of mosquitoes are there, you should use mosquito net, or you can use mosquito repellents. Then spray insecticides and control breeding of mosquitoes by not allowing water to collect in the surroundings. So if you take care of all this, if water is not stagnated, means there is no place for mosquitoes to lay egg. If they don't lay egg, there won't be mosquitoes again. So keep your surroundings clean and dry. By that you can prevent the breeding of mosquitoes, and use a net and mosquito repellents also. Okay, so by using following all these preventive measures, you can prevent yourself from the attack of all these microorganisms, and you won't be affected by these diseases also. Okay, clear, no? So today we study about the diseases that are caused by some microorganisms. So we study about diseases caused by bacteria, viruses, protozoa, and also study examples for diseases caused by virus, bacteria, protozoa, etc. Clear now? Okay, bye.